Good afternoon, Kestrel family. This is Dr. Mark Tracy coming to you with one of my weekly messages. What another great week of that ACE implementation we're having at Kestrel. Each and every week, I'm always impressed by the quality of work that our students are putting in each and every day in the classroom, but also our teachers every day. But today, I'm going to do a little twist on it. And usually, I highlight something that's going on in the classroom so you can see the kids and activities. But today, I want to focus a little bit more on some of the artifacts that are generated as a result of the hard work that our teachers and students are putting in. And so this week, when I was doing my walkthroughs in the classrooms, as I stepped out of classrooms, I took pictures of artifacts that were on the wall, either student work or sometimes billboards by the teacher, or a variety of different activities that you see on the wall. And we'll start off with our academics. You typically see academics along the walls of student work, and that's great. You know, one of the reasons why we emphasize student work is, you know, imagine when you were a kid, and I'm sure you probably do it nowadays, putting those quality work samples of your children on the refrigerator, when your work was put on the refrigerator, how it made you feel, and how it made you feel as far as a feeling of accomplishment. Well, I mean, that's a similar piece here where we get to highlight the quality of students and others get to see the quality of the work, but it also highlights what's going on in the classroom. It gives the rest of the school an opportunity to see what great activities are going on in each and every classroom. And so that's why we put those work samples up. So going on to the academic piece, there's a great piece of work. I won't go too long on each and every one of these, but you know, you'll see work with, for instance, around culture issues, around civil rights and how the impact of civil rights had in our culture. You go to something along with the science, where the characteristics of elements and seeing students take different elements and identifying the key components of it. You see here an opportunity for vocabulary development. This is something that a teacher put up and has opportunities for kids to continue to learn vocabulary. We know vocabulary is critical to student learning. You see, and also you see a variety of projects that students have completed over an extended period of time displayed throughout the school. So it's just great to see the diversity you see from different age groups, from kindergarten all the way up to eighth grade. Going on to the culture piece, we're going to start off with a project that our counselors did where we're focusing on those emotional sides of it and helping enrich our students holistically. But you also see our fifth grade looking at how to better implement our SOAR, which is our safety, ownership, attitude, and respect around our positive behavior and intervention and support. So you see them working on that. You also see some work around the future, planning, you know, the goals and aspirations, which is critical to student development. You see our teachers working on. You also see them working on the mindset. How do we get our kids out of a fixed mindset to a growth mindset? How do we get our kids to think about succeeding and not thinking about what's holding them back? And finally, you look at this kind of things we do around the holidays. You see a Valentine's Day writing sample, which is great, not just that they're celebrating a holiday, but they're also looking at different ways to increase writing within that. And finally, going to our enrichment piece, you see a board developed by our dance program that provides opportunities outside of our school, but enrichment opportunities too for those who really want to take that dance to the next level. Here's some great opportunities locally that they and their students and their families could potentially go to. You also have some work outside of our AIG room where our students have done some work. It looks like it's eighth grade or maybe our middle school group who have completed this. And finally, we have some artwork that outside of our art classroom in which students have really done a good job of following the directions of Miss Moan and Miss McCord, our art teachers. Next, I just wanted to highlight an event that happened last week, last Friday, which was our dance. We had our holiday dance, and I just wanted to highlight just beyond the dance component of it. The kids had a great time. We had staff showing up support. We had Mr. McKeever's, our band teacher, who was also our DJ. The purpose of that dance was not only for the kids to have a good time, but it was a fundraiser for our Model UN program. And we are the only charter school in the Durham area that has a Model UN. And these funds are going towards these students going to the state conference. And so the dance had multiple values to our organization. But I just want to say a great job to our Model UN students who helped out with snacks and things of that nature. But I also appreciate the community coming out to have a good time, but also support a very worthy cause at our school. Going into our National History Day this week, we had our National History Day. Our 8th grade students participated in National History Day, led by Mr. Hensler, our 8th grade ELA English Language Arts teacher, also working with Mr. Johnson, our 8th grade Social Studies teacher. But we had 19 students qualify for the regional National History Day. And what National History Day is, students research a problem or such a conflict and look at it from a variety of different ways and do a complete research program. And they had multiple ways they could have done it, from papers to exhibits to performances to websites. And we had 19 students qualified to go on to the regionals. Hopefully we'll get some of those from the regionals onto the state. But what a great job. Again, this is a great opportunity, both academic and culture and enrichment. To be honest, it really embodies the ACE that we try to uphold here at Kestrel. And finally, just wanted to let you know that the administration this week sat through a pretty intense training around safety in light of the incidents that happened in Florida. We got some great information from a national trainer on active shooting. We don't want to talk about that. We hope it will never happen, but safety is our number one priority, and it's our role and responsibility as administrators to make sure we're trained and prepared and we train our students. So we got some great information, and we'll implement these in the very near future and continue to train on a regular basis. An active shooter is very different than a lockdown, and we need to make sure our teachers know what to do and our students know what to do in these different situations. Unfortunately, that's where we're at today. We don't expect that to happen, but we're going to make sure we keep you and your children safe at Kestrel. So look, concluding up, I'm finishing up and just saying, hey, always looking for your feedback. If there's anything that we can do to better support you and your children during their educational journey here at Kestrel, please let us know. Here's how you can contact me. My contact information is there. Feel free to contact me at any time. Please follow us on social media. We have a Twitter page, a Facebook page, and our website. And we keep those updated as much as we possibly can. We usually tweet something once a day, and as well as Facebook adding things on a regular basis. So continue to like us on Facebook and or join our Twitter feed so that you can be kept abreast of what's going on. And obviously, please keep an eye out on our website. Please, note the second Tuesday of every month is our board meeting. We are always looking for board members. If you're interested, please let us know, and so we can get you connected with the board to see if it's a good fit. And a special announcement, finally, last bit of information, our middle school dance program is having their Black History Month dance recital on February 27th at 7 p.m. in the Annex, which was the gymnasium at the old high school. So again, this the February 27th at 7 p.m., in the Annex, we'll be having our middle school dance recital focused on our Black History Month. With that being said, have a great day. Hope you enjoy this weekend, and we'll see you back here on Monday.